Welcome, guys, welcome. Welcome to Helicopters Round 5. I'm your host with the most and a burnt bit of toast, 104th Maverick. Hope you guys are ready to get stuck into some more helicopter PvP action. Brought to you by the 104th and Alpenwolf. Here we are, ladies and gentlemen. This time it's going to be in southeastern Russia that we take the fight to. It looks like we're scrapping over the city of Tbilisi, so I beg your pardon, it's not southeastern Russia, it's eastern Georgia we're in, ladies and gentlemen. So we've got the red side south of the Tbilisi capital here, of the capital of Georgia, Tbilisi. Just north of the capital here, we have the blue side and their farps. Everybody's getting in and getting set up and ready to go. I've picked the worst time possible to make some food, so I'm sitting here trying to grab some food into my mouth before this starts. So just bear with me and we'll get the show on the road. Right, looks like we're slowly getting a lot of people in here now. Some good balance this time around for you. Oh shit, wrong one. 16, well, we've got more on the red side right now. The red side, they're almost full up. Look at this, guys. Got a great roster for you today, guys. Great roster. So currently we're on 19 versus 16. On the blue side, we have Snow Tiger, Camino, Neo, Voight, Condor, 08, which is Natch, Rhodes, 104th Tiger, Connor, we have from ECV56, we have Fox 1, Aggressor, Praetorian, we have DJ Switch, and representing the Fighting 99th, as always, Hera Mise. Guy's probably streaming right now, make sure you check out the stream on Twitch. From the Ugly Angels, we got Grizzly and Joker with another Ugly Angel, so we've got five Ugly Angels, Voy, Neo, and Cameo. With Grizzly and Joker, and we got this buster here, 104th Maverick, who is doing the commentary. On the red side, we got Commie One, shout out to the Comster, he'll be streaming as well, live on Twitch. And we have Eons, 104 Cadet Bullet, who I believe is also streaming. We have Frau as well, 51st Frosty, the man, the myth, the legend, coming up in the K50. Doesn't look like we got any 104th Mustang this round, so it makes it a little bit easier for the blue side. We got Baron on red with Rampage and Shady. We have from CBI, Requiem and Wyan. We have Wizard from the DW Squadron. We have Yambo from 4C. We have Skyman from LG. We have Jambox City from BW. Winter, Alpenwolf, the guy that comes up with and designs all these missions. And from Ross, we have Ollie and Pups with Titanfire as well, coming up in an MI8. So a good little mix. So we have 19 versus 15, basically, because I'm not a player here, so... This is going to be an interesting one, guys. I think that the red side really had a dominant show from last time. I mean, the blues did well with their Gazelle aircraft, but I think this is sort of stacked a little bit in the red favour. Although we'll see how it goes, because we are slightly in the, not totally in the mountains, but we're in some reasonable terrain for bobbing and weaving. So I think we're going to see a lot of bobbing and weaving today. Check in with the Frostman. So Alpenwolf's control in the start, he's saying the guys they can rearm, refuel, pick up crates and stuff, but do not take off. So we are here at the red forward operating base. Gonna throw some pasta into my mouth, guys, just bear with me. So we do have a stream delay today, guys, 30 seconds delay on the stream, so I apologise if I don't give a shout out to anyone or miss any questions. Hello to everybody watching, thank you so much for joining us, hopefully this is going to be another good one. just waiting on some guys getting bits and bobs sorted out. There's a call.
All units, Irene. I say again, Irene. Check him up ready. Armor 5-1 flight up and ready. Star 4-1 up and ready.
Irene!
For play, copy Irene.
Fucking Irene!
Fucking Irene! That's something you don't see every day. We'll be right back. Right, guys, looks like it's going to be close. Somebody fired their guns. Oh, come on, we're in a great shot here. A great position, but a great shot. Right, we're off! Red side, we have a decent little mass departure. Looks like they want to hold the MI8s at the back and send the K50s in first. Very sensible. Very sensible. The blues look like they're off as well, so we will check in with 104th Tiger. He's coming down downrange with Connor in trail. These guys looking good, feeling good, smelling fantastic. Well, they've got a little desert sort of, at least Tiger has anyway. He's got a little desert sort of camo, and that's going to go good with this autumn season that we're in just now. That's going to be a great bit of camouflage there. Let's see who else is up. So we have Aggressor, Switch. We have Mise coming down in the Huey in the back here. He's not taking any prisoners. From the red side, looks like tip of the spear is Yambo with Commie, Requiem, Wyan, and Bullet. Look at these guys, the ugly angels, looking beautiful angels, guys, rather than ugly angels, looking beautiful. So it looks like both sides really committing as many units as they can towards Bullseye. You see here that the reds are closing in pretty quickly, but so are the blues. So blues are only 6 miles to the north, and the K50s are just 8 miles. So the blues have slightly got the jump. We've got Aggressor leading the charge here. Looks like he's got a little bit of terrain to come over. Yeah, there's there on the right-hand side. So don't think any of the K50s see any of these guys. They're going to see them like the cavalry in the Wild West coming over the hill. They're going to be tally-vish any second now, so the separation between both pairings here, only 13 miles, 12 miles, so it's going to start, we're going to start seeing a weapon out pretty shortly. So red side spreading themselves out a little bit, we've got Yambo on the left, Requiem and the Comster in the middle, Bullet looking to flank out to the east a little bit. Blue sort of staying in a little bit of package. Everybody wants to come around the same sort of side of this hill. They're all just having a peek over now, saying, where are they? Nobody wants to be the first to die, so they're all just peeking over here. So you see, they don't see an awful lot as they're coming over the hill, so it's not as if they see a big swarm of them, so... A lot of them feeling pretty comfortable with just continuing to march south, and that is what they're doing. We have a Huey and Praetorian, Aggressor and Praetorian coming in first. I don't know how sensible that is. Maybe this is very sensible. These guys have probably got troops on board, and they're trying to get troops into Bullseye as fast as possible to reinforce with some, maybe some man pads or something like that. Those guys are planning to deploy. Whereas the Red Side coming up here, line abreast, five of them. With the MI8 sensibly in the back, they've got some K50s in the back, some good shots, we've got Frosty in the back. But leading the charge is Requiem, Bullet, Commie, Eons and Yambo. So these guys should be able to see the enemy now, they do have line of sight. Commie settling in just behind this little building here, he wants to get his camera out and start looking for people in the camera very sensibly. Bullet taking advantage of the altitude here. No one seems to. I don't think anybody's going to be targeted on this guy in a hurry. So, Bullet taking the altitude advantage wants to take the moral high ground as well as the literal high ground. He's going to be employing his weapons in a sensible fashion. He's only 8 miles away from these guys, so a little bit out of range at the moment. But if he can keep creeping forward, he's going to see some results. So we're on board here with Praetorian and his wingman. Coming into Bullseye, looks like they're wanting to get in low. Both guys got guns on, I'm not sure if these guys are dropping off troops or not. What's the MO here, chaps? What are we doing? They don't look like they're settling any land or anything, so maybe these guys just got big balls. Just big old regular balls. Separated by the two ship, Reaper 3-4 and 2-3. Rampage and Shady. Oh, one of them crashed. He flew into the power lines! How could you, bro? Oh, how could you? He flew into a train line! You don't want to do that, son! Alright, Praetorian, maybe thinking about landing, I'm not sure. Think about something anyway. He's thinking about a horrible experience that happened in his childhood. Right, so Rampage and Shady not far away, they're only 3 miles from him. Praetorian needs to hurry. If he's planning to land, he needs to hurry up and get on the ground. This is going to all kick off very soon. Look at this big package off to the east here. What is Praetorian doing? I think he is trying to land. Touching now. Oh shit. Get those troops out of there, bro. Oh, he's deploying a radar or something. Oh, he's got units on the ground. Nice. Will he escape, though? He's got Rampage 2 miles away. It looks like he might just thread a needle and get out of here, but he's done a good job to get this Humvee on the ground. If these guys get too close and low, they're in some big trouble. Here comes the L, Snow Tiger, looking to take on Wizard here. Wizard's in a bit of trouble if that L gets close enough. He is right off the nose. Fox out from Wizard. Tracking. Oh, he's in big trouble. Oh, he missed! Why would you change view? Did he get him? Yes, he took him out. He insta-killed him, that's why the camera jumped there. Sorry guys, so our first kill looks like it goes to Wizard, a good guns kill on Snow Tiger, who just kind of exposed himself a little bit too much, not in a good way. exposed himself right in the middle of no man's land, and yeah, got his, he paid the price here. Requiem looks like he's got a vicar out on this Humvee armor unit. Here comes a Fox 2 from Connor. And it did connect. Look, it did connect. We got the kill. The guy's still flying, though. I don't think he even knows he's been hit. So Connor doing a great job at taking advantage of the terrain that's on offer. He's got another one right in front of him. He's got Rampage right in front of him here as well. Doesn't, oh, it's Rampage is the guy who has landed. Oh no, he's still in the hover. He's still in the hover looking for him. So this might not be over for Connor. Connor might be getting some karma might be coming for Connor. We've got a big merge out here to the side as well. We've got another Humvee deployed at Vaziani by the looks of things. Eon's down there as well. Jesus Christ, there's some serious merges going on here. These guys are separated by 1 mile. They don't see each other. Here comes Neo. You've got a Vicar out on the... This looks like this is going for the helicopter. Oh, ho, 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 ho. That is about as close as you can get, ladies and gentlemen, to actually hitting a guy and not hitting him. Oh, he takes him down. Nice, that was Yambo. That was 4C Yambo getting the kill there on Switch. So Yambo with some good standoff distance there. He was more than 2 miles away, so feeling comfortable. Here comes another Mistral out. This time it's on our man Wizard. I don't think he sees it. Boom! Still okay though. No fucks given here. So Connor's got to be thinking about getting another one. Does he even have any left? Yeah, he does. Missiles lost track. Now Connor needs to be careful here. He's got Rampage closing in on his six, and he's close as well, 1.5 miles in the back. We have an Mi-28. Looks like he... Excuse me. Looks like he's trying to get some guns down on these ground units. Maybe not the safest place to do your insertion, sir, but hey, I'm not going to be a hater. He's on the ground. He's going to get some troops off. He needs to stop moving forward, though, or this Humvee's going to take him out. Sounds like his engine's shutting down. Look at his tire. His tire's all shredded. Not going too well for our man Jambok. Misa's on the crawl. He's heading straight towards Rampage. It looks like he's definitely targeted, but the problem is he needs to get really close with the guns on the Huey there. We have Eons merged with Camino and Voight. I'm trying to pick who to choose here. Connor, yeah, Connor managed to land with some damage. Misa trying to come to the rescue and just get some vengeance for his wingman Connor there. I think he's opened up just a little bit too early to sort of the game's up now. He definitely knows we're coming. I mean, these helicopters do carry a lot of rounds, but they're sadly they're not. Can Frosty connect? Oh, it just missed. Oh, no, it doesn't look like it missed Frosty. A good kill. Good long-range kill by Frosty there. Doing the sensible thing and just getting a bit of standoff range and getting some. Here's another one. What is Camino doing? He's right in the middle of it. He's got Frosty right on top of him. He's got the Comster right off his nose. Does Commie see him? Oh yeah, Commie's engaging with guns. Oh. Oh, Commie's in trouble. Commie's in trouble. The Gazelle. Taking him to school there, just came round the corner. He couldn't get the guns on him in time and the Gazelle just ran right up to him and shot him. But mind you, he's still okay. He's obviously had his porridge and his iron brew this morning. Watch out for the trees, Gazelle, for fuck's sake. Commie doing a good job just to keep the nose on him. I think he might be trying to land though. There's another K-50 coming in to support. So that's good teamwork by the red side there. Camino and all sorts of, having all sorts of fun now. He's the danger man at the moment, the guy that's mixed up with, he's behind a lot of them, Misa's still trying to run down Rampage. We do have some more reinforcements now from the blue guys that were taken down early coming in. Nice little merge here between Camino and a K50. This L model Gazelle is really dangerous. Look, he's taking someone else to school. Down he goes. So some good shots from Camino. He's got Eons and Frosty and Rampage now sorted on him. Trying to get over there. Commie's on the radio. I'm sure he's saying what he can see. Right, it's Frosty coming in. Just having a bit of trouble getting some nose on this Gazelle flight model, famously not the most realistic flight model that we have available in the game. Camino with some good nose up here, and he should be careful, he just starts sinking down, but some good shots out. Shoot him if you got him. Come on Camino, let's go bro, we got loads of rounds, let's go, get him out, go. Oh, someone hit him! Eons killed him! Eons insta-killed him! He must have killed his pilot. Another quirky bug about the Gazelle is when the pilot gets killed, the aircraft just despawns straight away. It just disappears. It's a bit silly. So Misi, in a bit of trouble here. Misi's seen better days, guys. He's managed to get it down on the ground though, like a trained professional. Those guys will work that out. They'll trim that. They'll push that aircraft over, trim it out. That'll be fine. That'll be absolutely fine. So we've got Eons and Rampage heading west. Titan Fire southbound. Frosty looks like he might be thinking about RTB. We have Natch, who's committing eastbound towards this two-ship trailing to the west, who are hot. Two K-50s just sort of loitering around. Those guys are, again, using the cameras just to get some intel. Just to find out, hey, who's who in the zoo and where are these guys? Those are the K-50s turning northbound now, possibly don't see Natch here. Natch is in an L, so he needs to get close with the guns, possibly targeted on Eons, who's only 2 miles off the nose now. Oh, Rampage just hit one! From Tiger! Tiger with another shot, here it comes! Looks like it's missed. So good old Tiger, he definitely sees him, he's just waiting for him to stop flaring. Hey Cole! Thanks for the sub bro, resub on the Prime for 8 months in a row, what a goddamn boss. My very first Twitch subscriber. He's still with me. I love this guy. Alright, good fox out again from Tiger. Looks like it's tracking. Boom, that's all she wrote. That is all she wrote, ladies and gentlemen. You ain't saving that shit. Oh Christ, he might actually. He might. We are going down, folks. Yep, down he goes. That's a kill on Rampage by 104th Tiger. Great job, buddy. Great job. Here's, oh shit. Eons and I don't think Eons knows he's merged. Eons definitely doesn't know he's merged yet. Come on, Natch, make it count, buddy, make it count. Shit, bro! Took him down, son. Now Natch getting engaged by the red ground units. It's too little too late, I'm afraid. This guy's a certified boss, a trained professional, he's getting out of there. So the blue side definitely been able to hold their own here, guys. Definitely some friction coming out of blue side. They're not just getting rolled over like they were the last time. Although I'd like to see the Gazelle sticking together a little bit more. We have the two Hueys from ECV 56, Fox 1 and Aggressor turning up. They do have an enemy BRDM on the airbase here. I wonder if he's going to come in and play a part. So yeah, he is engaging. Fox 1. I don't think Fox 1 knows he's been engaged yet. He's just hit the ground. Dude. Ah, oh, bro, we need that. Ah, never mind, sir. Never mind. No one's perfect. The aggressor getting his unit onto the ground there. I'm not sure if we're going to see some ground wars here. Yes, we are. So the Humvee opening up on the BRDM. Not sure what the results we're going to get on this are. Yeah, the BRDM's now engaging us. We're in a soft target here. This is not good for the good guys here, guys. Not good for the good guys here, guys. There's too many G's in that. There's too many goods and too many guys, Maverick. Oh, he's moving. Look at that. Right, doesn't look like it's going to end well for that guy. Although Aggressor coming around in a flanking maneuver, he's maybe thinking about putting some rounds on him. That's exactly what he's trying to do. Looks like right-hand side Bob is engaging. Shoot him, Bob. What the fuck? God damn it, Bob. Alright, we've got Hellrequeem pushing in on Natch and Snow Tiger, both in Gazelle L, so they both need to get him into the merge. Wyan is just nestled here in the Eagle's Nest. He's trying to maybe cover. Oh shit. Some rocket action going down from a man, Snow Tiger. So watch out, some effective rounds coming up there. He's running in with a cannon. That's a bold move, sir. And he takes up the... Yeah, unfortunately, like we just discussed, like we just mentioned, you definitely do need a tail rotor to take... a main rotor to take part in this event. If you lose your main rotor, I'm afraid you're out. Right, Aggressor flowing northwestbound. Requiem looks like he is getting friendly fired from... No, this is going to be... Excuse me, Bullet or Commie launching on Natch. Natch is kind of high, but he's bobbing around. He's going to be a hard target to hit. I think they missed. Yeah, they would have hit by now. So someone else is going to take a shot at him because someone sees him. One of these two guys see him. In fact, it's got to be Wyan. It has to be Wyan. Or in fact, maybe Commie or Bullet in the back. I don't think Requiem sees him. Damn! Requiem is way up here, but he's got all his lights on and stuff like that. That was risky. Risky AF. Look, he's right above him. They definitely don't see each other. He's going to go right below him as well. They're going to just end up flying just past each other there. So the reinforcements are coming in from the red, and blue are trying to bolster their line as well. Sorry about all these bugged images on the thing. What we got? Generator, generator, generator. Maybe no generators for next time. So these two are merged, but don't think they're going to end up seeing each other. Well, here comes Alpen. So I think Condor is sorted on the two MI8s, the two Stalin buses coming in. I think he's talking to the AWACS. Because he's got his nose in the direction he's looking for this guy, I think. Or maybe he does see him, actually. This could be interesting. Yeah, he definitely sees him by now. Oh, this K50's in so much trouble. Oh, someone hit him with a Mistral! Oh, he didn't even get a chance to shoot him. Someone hit him with a Mistral. That was fucking beautiful. Who was it? Oh, so it was Connor. Connor just totally stole took the wind out of Natchi's sails, totally just said, sorry bro, I'm going to take that one, and they hit him with the, there's Connor there, hit him with the Mistral. Nice little flanking manoeuvre here by Frau and Baron, looking to get around a couple of ugly angels here. We've got Neo and Voight, we've got ECV 56 Praetorian looking to come in and hopefully, possibly look at reinforcing Sogenlug with some ground units, but these K50s definitely coming into play. What we got going on at Vassiani? Connor and Natch coming in. Looks like they're going to be squaring off against Alpen and Skyman. Alpen got his generator deployed. Not 100% sure. Not 100% sure why it's calling that a generator. Oh, maybe it is a generator. Oh no, that's just a bug on the thing. Never mind. So he's got a BRDM out. The problem is he's got a friendly there to his right. It's really this Mistral he needs to be looking out for. He's just in fact, that's a, I think that's a Huey that's on the other side there. Oh, it's two Gazelles. He needs to be very careful. That'd be a great shot if he could see those two guys. He could run in with guns and get both of them while they're on the ground. I don't think that's going to happen. Possibly Skyman may have the opportunity to do it, although he is turning south. Come on, Alpen, bro, turn left. They have a Gazelle M just overwatch here. He's just trying to get visual on some people before he commits to anything. That's a sensible thing to do. Here's Alpenwolf coming in. He might see Connor now. Oh shit! We're hit, we're going down. Oh no, we're okay. Another MIA behind us, still got his lights on, not a great idea. I think Natch is now targeted on Alpen after he was smoking there, but he's got Skyman coming in. I don't know who Skyman's targeted on, this is the guy with the lights on. Multiple Vickers coming in from long range, possibly from Bullet on Condor. Boom! Takes him out the fucking game! Bullet with a pow pow motherfuck. Straight to the beak. Connor returning fire on Bullet. Bullet doesn't see it. Boom! That's justice for you, son. So certainly an eventful event for Connor so far. He's got multiple targets of opportunity right for those. Hopefully he's got some weapons. Fox 2 again on Bullet. Fox 2 and the guy to the left as well, this guy's shooting McTootin! Oh, he connects on both of them, that's beautiful dude, that's absolutely beautiful. This guy shot me down in a 1-on-4 server about 2 hours ago, this guy's having a fucking great day. Oh, he's got someone battling, an MI8 battling in right behind him now, trying to come in for some vengeance. Bullet is the guy on our right firing the gun, still just, he's been hit by two air-to-air Mistral weapons and he's still just out there, just wishing. Right, here comes the rounds from this MI8 trying to get me. Ah, he's done the worst possible thing, he's turned back into him. Mind you, Connor has the advantage here because he's more manoeuvrable. Who are we running from? We have, so Connor, he has Jambo and Skyman in the back, both in Stalin buses. This is Alpenwolf trying to get some fucking guns on. Well, I think he got him. He did, we're going down, guys. Boom. Another gazelle coming in to the rescue though. Some serious rounds coming onto Alpenwolf here. Connor is down. That's what you get for shooting me down, bro. That's karma. Kidding on Connor. Done a great job. We've got Camino chasing down Skyman. Skyman's down. That's going to take a couple of days to get that fixed. Commie in the Eagle's Nest here. What's the old Comster up to? He's just hustling. He's hiding like a leopard in the trees there. Just wishing. Two Hueys with their balls right out, just flowing way south of Bullseye, trying to intercept the Reds that are coming in on the transit north. It's a great idea. Camino with the rockets out on some ground units. Not sure how effective that was. Oh no, he's trying to finish off a helicopter that's down there. That's an MI-8. Yeah, it looks like we're coming in with guns here. The MI-8 managed to get his BRDM off and deployed on the ground, so he's trying to get out of Dodge. K-50 trying to come to the rescue as well. We are taking some ground fire, ladies and gentlemen. So Camino's going to try and get out of here to the north. Where are these guys? I want to see the... Oh, they might see Yambo. Oh, they definitely see these guys. This is going to be beautiful. Come on, Hueys. Let's get in there. Don't like everybody think, don't fire too early. Everyone say that out loud. Do not fire too early. Oh man, Yambo is in big trouble. Here comes death, Yambo! Oh, bro! Ah, oh, down he goes. Sort of. Right, I think that's kinda... Now they're trying to hit this MI-8. This is gonna be... Oh, this MI-8 should have just ran away. Should have ran away, bro. He's hit. Awesome. So some good kills from the two Hueys there. Taking no nonsense. Here comes some reinforcements from the north though. I don't think he sees them. The Stalin bus is definitely targeted on us though. We are smoking bad. Uh oh! Oh, that was a mid air, guys. That was a mid air. We lost our tail rotor. There goes the main rotor. Hopefully, Grizzly can maybe get some vengeance. He should see this guy. Oh, I think they see each other. Shoot him if you got him. Right, he's in all sorts of... Well, he might get away with this. No one else seems to see that. Grizzly is trying to run pups down here. We got anything else going on? Here's Commie creeping. Is anyone targeting Commie? Just... He's gone from the leopard hiding in the trees to the madman running through the streets with no clothes on and a bottle of vodka shouting, come at me. Grizzly may be going, yeah, Grizzly's seen better days, guys. We're gonna get the RAC called out. We'll get this fixed. Get it back up. We'll get it trimmed out again. And he'll be fine. So it looks like the Reds have re-established their dominance. Someone else just went down. Titan Fire getting a great kill there. Unfortunately, we missed that. But he's... Who was it? Ah, it doesn't say. But Titan Fire doing a great job. Hustling in the Stalin bus. He's taking no prisoners. No prisoners. Oh, he needs to be careful, though. He's got Rhodes just creeping 1.4 to the north. Rhodes must see this. No, he doesn't even see him. He's targeted on the other guy farther away. Look, there's Titan Fire there on the left. Oh, Titan Fire might see. Rhodes has still got his strobe light on the back of his aircraft, so... Does Titan Fire see him, or is Rhodes going to see him? Rhodes is shooting at someone. What the fuck was that? That's a hot free! Rhodes has his head in the camera targeting ground units, and he's got an enemy MI-8 flying straight over the top of him. He doesn't see him because he'll be focused right on the camera right now. Ah, bro, you're going to watch this back and kick yourself. Unlucky Rhodes! Titan Fire might be getting talked on. Does he see him? Oh, this is going to be beautiful if he sees him. I don't think he sees him. So Titan Fire is on top of this guy right now. And not in a good way. There's another hot free out by Rhodes. So again, he's just engaging more ground targets. Doesn't see the threat in the air. He's a very lucky boy. Alright, Kami is in Super Secret Alpha 1. So he is just hoping, just praying. Someone's going to just stick their head out. And you Dr. Disrespect fans out there, don't you dare peek! That's what Kami's sitting there shouting right now. Just you, don't peek! Is Kami going to see him? He's going to go fucking right past him. Kami's like, oh, there's a guy. So Kami running after him. Come back here. Is he going to try in a little cheeky air-to-air shot with the Vickers here? He needs to be quick before he gets too far away. He's getting that nose up, so yeah, he's looking at him in this camera. He has him in the sensor. He's trying to let. There it goes. It's a little bit wobbly, but we're tracking. Oh shit, that was close, dude. Hopefully, he's remembered to select air to air mode because the weapons are a little bit straggly coming off the rail. Gazelle doing a great job to just get out of the way. It looks like he's going to come back for the recommit though. No, he's going to try and make it over the trees. Has made it over the trees. Needs to get his nose down now. Alright, looks like that Wabbit got away. Camino doing a great job to get away there. He needs to be careful. Kami needs to be careful. He's got Natch to his 095, who's now flanking. Aggressors behind him as well. We have Rhodes still just chilling down here. I love this guy. Just look at how many fucking people are flying around you. God damn you, Rhodes! He might see some air targets now. He's sort of wandering the nose around a little bit. He has a Rampage flanking around to his east. He has Titan Fire flanking on the west. And he's got Requiem right in front of him. He's still head down in the camera looking for this ground target. Here comes Titan Fire with some good altitude. He must see this Huey right in front of him. He does. He's nose down now. Here we go. Come on, Titan Fire. Oh, easy bro, easy! Oh shit, it's getting real! Oh, this will be beautiful if we can just work it out. Maybe just come to the right. Just come all the way around to the right. Give yourself a bit of space. Not exactly a nimble aircraft to fly, the old MI-8, but I mean, it's not too bad. But it certainly can't turn on a dime like the Gazelle can. Right, Rampage heading north. Don't know where. Not sure where Rampage is going. He's looking to take advantage of the situation. Commie has Voight coming at him in the next kind of 30 seconds in an L, so Voight will need to get close to try and use the gun there. Where's Titan Fire again? Where did he go? He's heading out eastbound. Here we go. Here's a little merge. Oh, some good hits by the K-50, some good hits. K-50, maybe just assuming he got that kill there. A nice little rocket attack from Pups on the units that we just seen that the Huey that Titan flew over. He deployed some units on the ground at Vaziani, and Pups just coming in and saying, sorry guys, we're close for business. So my man Bullet looking like he's going to get caught sleeping. Well, this is not healthy. This is not good for Bullet's health, guys. Warning. Objects on stream may be closer than they appear. Oh, this does not look good. This does not look good. Oh, someone saved him! Someone fucking saved him! Who was that? That was Frau! Oh my god, Bullet, you owe your life to Frau! That was a great gunshot as well. That was a fantastic gunshot. All the while, Bullet was targeted on a guy 3 miles away. And he gets him. That was, yeah, Bullet hit that guy. Bullet did hit him. Aggressor, I think that was. I think it was a double. He was double targeted with Requiem, so I think they both hit him, but yeah. Here's my man, Rhodes. Looks like Eons is possibly targeted on him. 1.7 miles. Eons is at nearly 2,000 feet and climbing. So, I think he's looking for him. He's maybe got words on the wind. Hey bro, there's someone over there. Requiem, right on top of a K-50 here. Not a great shot there to open up with. I don't think the Huey's seen him. Oh, cold pasta. It's actually not so bad. Oh, that's a good shot. There goes something. Boom, down he goes. Great shot. That was Requiem taking down Praetorian with a gun. Nice job, dude. Nice job. Here's Rhodes. I love this guy. Can we buy shares in Rhodes, guys? Is that... If you get the option to buy any stock in Rhodes PLC, I would heavily invest. Heavily invest, guys. That'd be my financial advice. Alright, Pup's creeping. Ollie's creeping as well. Looks like he wants a shot at this, Humvee. Humvee's engaging him. Doesn't look like we have any options to come back at him with, though. He is now flown south. Here's Commie. He's sort of flying perpendicular to our man from the Ugly Angels, Voight. So the Comster. 2.5 miles. Inside the 2.5 miles. He's going to find himself in a bit of trouble. He's got company on the left. His left. And a company behind him as well, so... Well, it looks like Voight wants to flank down sort of in this direction. He's got a lot of aircraft to be shooting. I think Bullet's in the high sort of cap. Well, he's only 1600, but I think Bullet's in his sensor looking to the north for people coming in sensibly. Ollie Pups and Alpenwolf, all Stalin buses here on the river. These guys are just creeping around south of Tbilisi trying to work something out over Soganlug. 99th Misi coming in from the west. Neo from Ugly Angel and a couple of other, another two Ugly Angels, Grizzly and Jokers. Looks like coming in. So Voight might be targeted on Commie now. There's not a lot of distance between them. 1.6 miles. Does he have line of sight? Let's get his fucking plate passed out the road. No, there's commie there. They do not see each other. So it looks like commie is homeward bound. He's certainly got a clear run at it if he wants to go home. He's 15 miles to the south there. He's not got far to run. Voight is just totally taking a different angle now. He's going totally west. Like, totally. So the Comster over Vaziani with Bullet and Frosty, who are both northbound. Looks like they see, maybe they see our stock investment roads. Missed. As soon as I take it off, it hits him. He's going to be wanting to take another shot. He missed then again. A lot of K50s with their lights still on. This one's on the money. Boom! What the fuck? This thing's still alive. It's gotta be bugged. Gotta be bugged. I'm sure he's hit him at least twice. Right, some ugly angels northwest of Tbilisi looking to come south. Wizard's done a good job at clearing Soganlug. We have Bullet and Switch with Requiem in the north here. Those guys are going to end up getting mixed up. I'm not sure what the Comster's doing. Oh. We'll find out what happened later. Although it's a red airbase, he may be landing to rearm and refuel. Maybe that's what he's doing. Although, it would have been ideal if he remembered the landing gear, but hey, I'm not judging. I am not judging. MI8 squaring off against the Gazelle L. Let's do it. So these guys are not going to see each other. He's too low for them, those two guys. They don't have line of sight right now, so I think it's going to be these two. I think this MI8 is going to run into the two Hueys that are not far away, 1.9 miles. Frau right over, looks like he's targeted right over Vaziani on Switch. Someone else is shooting a Switch. Don't think Frau sees him. Oh, Switch is going down. Unlucky Switch. Unlucky, sir. That was someone on the right. I was thinking that was Shady. Shady that took him down. Right, this has the possibility to escalate. Oh, look how close this guy is to the other Gazelle. Both you, you see him. This guy doesn't see him though. He's going to wish he flew a little bit higher when he watches the stream replay, but it looks like both these Hueys possibly targeted on the MIA, unless he's a little bit lower now. No, they should still see him. Yeah, looks like they're definitely targeted. Death is coming, sir. So we're on board with BW Jambok. Let's see how this goes. Sergeant May, thanks for the sub on the Prime, my man. DB Explorer, thanks for the sub. PLZ, please, 3-4. Sorry, I don't know how to pronounce that old name, dude. Thanks for the sub. The Prime for 2 months. Thanks, boss. Welcome, guys. Welcome. Sorry, I've got a 30-second delay here on the stream. I'm obviously trying to keep my eyes on what's going on. So sorry if I missed any shout-outs, any hellos or anything. Welcome, guys. Welcome. Thanks for joining us. This is Helicopters Round 5. Brought to you by Alpenwolf and the Cold War server in association with our good selves at the 104 Phoenix. So Eon's on the creep. Where's Eon's? He's up at 2,300. Looking north. Definitely doesn't see this little free ship to the west here. We've got Jambok in the MI8, who was merged with these guys over here, has now found himself over Tbilisi with Aggressor and a Huey behind him to the west. So maybe the Ugly Angels are possibly trying to target Eons. I think Eons is, he's not ridiculously high, but he is higher than everybody else. So these guys possibly targeted on him, certainly within 2 miles. Doomtone, thanks for the resub on the Prime, champ. Welcome. Thanks for your support, guys. I'm really glad you could join us. Support my old tired ass as well. Thanks, guys. Right, come on, bro. Who we got? Neo. Let's get him. Let's hunt him down, Neo. Oh, shit. We're going to shoot that. Some ground units, I think. Oh, game's up, dude. The game's up. He knows we're coming. Good rounds, good rounds. Come on, bro, take your shots. Get him out. Fire, fire, fire. Shoot him if you got him. Uh-oh. Oh, dear. That is not good. Oh, we got taken out. What killed us? I think that was a ground unit's firing at us, guys. We got taken out. Here comes Frau. He's a great shot with the cannon we've seen earlier on. He's coming in with some great ground speed as well. He needs to be careful he doesn't overshoot this guy. Oh, he's going to go right over him! What's up, Fallen? Good to see you, buddy. Frau, in his enthusiasm to commit to the fight, flew right over it. Angel, one of the angels just hanging around here, trying to use the trees as cover. Frau's going to go right over him as well. Come on, Frau, what is this, bro? The Huey driver sees him, but he's not fast enough to catch him. And it would only be, if he starts shooting at him, that's stupid. You're just going to give your position away. Oh, Eons just flew right over that Huey as well. God damn it, these guys definitely don't have a fighter controller to tell them who's who in the zoo and where they are, because no one seems to be targeted on anyone. So my man Eons is up here at nearly 3,000 feet. He has a Huey half a mile below us. Two aircraft right down there. Holy shit. If this Gazelle sees him, he's in big trouble. I think the Gazelle is climbing for us, guys. Yes, the Gazelle is definitely targeted on us. Who the fuck are we shooting at? Oh, he got someone! Nice! That was a great shot, dude. Eon's killing aggressor there. That was a great shot, sir. Credit where credit's due. Right, where's this fucking Gazelle? One right below us. All sorts of nonsense going on. He seems to be high enough to just avoid all the trouble. He's got the two Hueys down below him. They can't do shit. They've got to climb all the way up there. He's got Frosty coming in to support. Holy shit, what's Bullet doing? This Camino flew right past him. Bullet's in an interesting setup here. He's looking south. What the fuck? Some bro just flying around the blue farp. My man Rampage, he's just up here wheeling and dealing. Road sees him. Can Rhodes do anything about him though? Here comes Wyan as well. There's some serious base attacking action going on here. Bold by the red side, bold. Camino and Shady. You don't wanna fuck with Shady. What? Shady will get shot in the face. Shady is about to get shot in the face. Or maybe in the rear. Right, don't start firing too early, Camino. Get close enough to be accurate and then open up, bro. I like this guy's style. He's nose down trying to get some feckin' ground speed. This guy's not taking any prisoners. Now start slowing down now. Nice and easy. Ah, oh, come on. Oh, he's done it. He's done it. Good job, sir. Perfect. Perfect. Love this guy. Someone needs to tell that K50 he's just been shot. Right, we've got Commie in this bro now. So Camino, he's not. He doesn't. I don't know if he knows Commie's there, but Commie is close. He's turning in for him. Commie might be in a big bit of trouble here. Don't think the Gazelle driver sees him though. He's turning right through him. No, Camino does not see him. So the Comster and Bullet floating around Tbilisi sort of area. They don't really have any other blue coming in from the north at any time soon. I'm not sure what's going on in terms of player numbers. Ah, maybe that's why we're not seeing so many blue guys are running out of lives. We only have five of them left. Look how many reds we have left. Holy shit, son. Here's Grizzly trying to gun down Wizard. Come on, Grizzly. We all believe in you, sir. Oof! Oof! Ambitious! Use the fucking gun, sir. Oh, that was close. Careful, 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 careful. Maybe he doesn't have any guns left. Oh, that was close, bro! totally legit. 100% legit. As we all know, guys. Everybody knows this, alright? Since we were all children, we've all been taught, if you're being chased by an enemy helicopter, hide in a single-story car park. That's what you're looking to do. Everyone knows this. It's common knowledge. Alright, we've got rolled up. No one really setting the world on fire. We got Wizard with 3 kills. Requiem's got 2 kills. Pups is on 2. Bullet's on 1. Baron's on 1. Camino's on 1. Commie's on 1. Rhodes is on 1. My man Rhodes. Love this guy. He's heading back in there for some more action. We don't have any blues kinda close though, unfortunately. That's a little bit disappointing. The blues are running out of steam. Shout out to my man Heramise. Thanks for the host, my friend. Welcome. Some great flying, sir. Unfortunately, the blue side just a little two out match today. Where the fuck is Wyan going? Oh, that old fucking chestnut. The old, I'ma just hover over the enemy's base and just massacre anybody trying to leave. How uncouth, sir? How dare you? Somebody get me that man's mother on the phone. Alright, Rolds and Rampage are the closest sort of adversaries at 4 miles. Commie's coming up for the fight though, he's 7 miles away from our man Rolds here. It doesn't look like we're going to get the full 2 hours out of it, guys. It looks like this is going to be over in the next kind of 15, 20 minutes, 30 minutes or something. We don't have a lot of blues left, we're running low on blues. So the comps are low, he's on his way north. He's just probably been given the word, hey dude, there's not a lot of blues left. If you want a fight, you're going to have to go hunting for it. I don't think they have any fighter controller to give him the bra, but he is within 5 miles. Well, man Rhodes here, very sensibly, just keeping it as low as possible. He is in the Mike version of the Gazelle, so he doesn't have the super air-to-air weapons. I think this guy only has the rockets. I don't think he can shoot down. I don't think this guy has guns. He only has the hot free rockets. Yeah, so I'm giving this guy shit for not going after other enemy aircraft. This guy is knocking it out of the park. He's just trying to avoid as many enemy aircraft as possible and get his air-to-ground weapons off. Very sensible, sir. Very sensible. It looks like he's going to have to get past Frosty, which is, if you know anything about DCS multiplayer, not the easiest task to accomplish. Frosty, one of the most well-known, certainly one of the most feared SU-27 pilots that you'll see online. He's been flying for the 51st Squadron for more than 10 years. The guy's outrageously experienced, outrageously talented. He is my counterpart at the 51st. He is the commanding officer of the 51st. And he's been doing a great job for the past, I think he's been doing it for the past couple of years now. He's been doing a great job. Those guys going from strength to strength. Getting stronger every week. We, the 104th, we're proud to call them our friends. Good old 51st. Right, Frosty, possibly going for the enemy AWACS. There's no chance Rhodes is going to see him. There's our man Rhodes. It's going to go right under Frosty. There's no way these two are going to see each other. No way. So maybe Frosty's just tequila, vodka and whiskey. He's calling the shots from up there. Wyan looks like he just converted all his... Oh, I was going to say all his altitude into airspeed, but he's still up there. He's about 9,000 feet now. Camino is possibly maybe trying to run him down, but Frosty will definitely see Camino from... Because he's probably had his camera in this location for a good while, so he probably actually seen Camino take off. So he knows where they are. His roads. Roads might be... Roads is not climbing, and Frosty is not descending. So these guys don't see each other. Look at this shit. Holy god. They're literally right on top of each other. The literal meaning of, hey, that guy's right on top of you. Thing is, if Frosty was just to throw it over and look down, he would see the rotor wash from the Gazelle on the ground. Plus, it's much easier to see the aircraft shadow than it is to see the actual aircraft. Well, it looks like we've got a Vicar out from Wizard. Looks like this is on Camino. I don't think that's going to reach. Oh! It's on someone that's already on the ground. And he got him. That was... someone killing someone else. Sorry guys, I didn't actually say who that was. Oh shit, here we go. Ah, Frosty's still away up. There's no way he's going to see Camino from there. No way. Oh, that was our man Rhodes. That's who we just watched getting shot. That was Rhodes. God damn it, I love that guy. Alright. Wizard and Camino should be targeted on each other. Looks like Camino sees us. Camino definitely sees us, guys. I was going to say maybe Wizard's getting a call, but he doesn't really. Well, he's maybe getting a call now. He's putting a little bit more energy into the aircraft. So maybe someone getting on the radio saying, hey, bro, there's someone right fucking behind you. Shots coming up. Some good little bursts from the Gazelle pilot there. You need to get the rounds out on that helicopter. It's got a very powerful cannon. So you need to be thinking accuracy by volume, guys. You have a lot of ammunition in that aircraft. See, look at that. One lucky hit takes his engine down. The commie's been hit as well, so we... I don't think that... What was that commie that just got shot down? No, that was Wizard. That was Wizard, but unfortunately we lost commie as well. Here's Frosty on the charge to the north. So I think it's just these two left on blue side, guys. We're down to just two guys left. Three, sorry. We've got Praetorian down there. Who might be trying to sneak up on Eons. What's Eons doing? 2,000? He's at 2,000 as well. So these guys are co-altitude, separated by 1.5. Yambo looks like he may be targeted. Yambo's at 7,000. And he is, he's moving. He is possibly targeted on Praetorian here. Don't think there's anybody else coming up. There's Rhodes. It's back there. So maybe Rhodes got some more lives. Frosty might not even let them off the ground though. I see aircraft smoking on the pads. Interested to see if Frosty is going to allow these guys to get airborne. He might just be totally denying them the ability to even get in the air, never mind actually get near the fight. There's no one merged right now. We have Titan Fire. It looks like he's going to be merged with Camino in an L, so this is going to be good for Titan Fire if he can pull this one off. Co-altitude, so they should see each other soon. Oh no, I don't think Titan Fire sees him. And Titan Fire is driving the Stalin bus, so the Camino definitely sees us. One thing Titan's got from his airspeed right now. Should be seeing this yellow shit whizzing past the cockpit. It looks like the Gazelle's going to give up just as Titanfire recommits. Kami, thanks for the raid, dude. Hope you enjoyed it, man. I know you got at least one kill. We were, yeah, unfortunately, we didn't manage to catch it, but we seen you setting up the ambush there, and the guy fly right past you. That was unlucky not to catch him. Right, here we go. We've got the Gazelle. Camino is going to be merged with the K50. Camino just trying to just get a bit of serpentine on, just to avoid getting shot in the face. Oh, great, great nose up there, dude. Took a little bit of the K50 with him, not much though. What is going on here? Right, so the K50 just extending its legs and getting away. The Gazelle's not a very fast helicopter. Oh, it is very lethal though. It's incredibly lethal. If you can just get a couple of these rounds on target, even on a K50, it'll snap a K50 in half. So he has some good rounds there on this K50. It looks like he's going down. No, he's still out. He may even fire back. I think this is Titanfire trying to get involved. Sounds like the Gazelle's going down though. Boom! Mino is down. Titanfire may get a chance. Oh, yep. Some heavy rounds coming into him. Get him, Titan! Get him! Oh. What happened there? Uh-oh! No! Oh dear. Frosty seems to be getting Sam's thrown at him as well now. So Camino's dead. We know Camino's... Yeah, there it goes. So I think that is it, guys. I think that's all she wrote. Alright, let me find out. Hold on. I don't think Frosty sees that he's getting shot. Oh, someone took him down! Oh, it was a Vulcan. Frosty just caught sleeping. Well, not really caught sleeping, but you know what I mean. Taken by surprise by a Vulcan. Well, I'm pretty sure that's it over, guys. Hold on.
Channel switched. Right side.
Is that it, guys?
Right. Hey, yeah, man.
Hey, there's 30 minutes in the event left, but I don't think there's any blues left.
Gotta be 30 minutes.
Are you gonna keep playing for 30 minutes?
I gotta get my walking boots on. I'm going back to the base.
Well, if you don't have to, then we don't have to.
No, there's no blues guys alive.
So we won.
A firm.
Okay, well.
I'd say we just didn't lose.
I'll jump on the wing, Eon.
And we
you,
got Viziani too,
here.
And Lucini, alright?
Nice.
So, Matt, if you can bring down the server in 5 minutes.
I'll bring it down in 5. You guys can get any like a debrief channel. I'll set one up now. Hold on.
Right. Thanks, buddy.
Thanks, guys. Channel switched. Alright, stream, bear with me a second. Channel edited. Right, champs, that's going to be it. We're going to leave the server running for another 5 minutes, but that is going to be... Oh, hold on. Rampage is shooting something. That's going to be it for this round of Helicopter Wars, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. I think this round was good fun. I don't really have anything bad to say about it. I would say the last one was probably a bit more fun, though. I don't know how you guys feel about watching on the stream. This definitely did work, though. I think this was a great round. So hopefully we can try and get some more people for the next time it's on, which should be... Oh, this helicopter's going to get killed on the pad. Oh, went back to spectators. So April, May... No, so it should be in April. We should have the next helicopters round 6 should be in April, guys. So if you want to take part in the round in April, get yourself an account on ED forums and look out for the sign up, which is posted by Alpenwolf, and get yourself signed up, guys. Anyone can sign up that has any DCS helicopter that's part of the event. Normally we let all 4 take part. Red guy coming in to land at a blue airbase. There's something you don't see every day. This was a great, another great event. Shout out to Alpenwolf for making the mission and coming up with the sort of format and the theme. Great job, dude. Great job. I certainly enjoyed watching. Red's just returning back victorious. Remember the landing gear, bro. Don't do all that fancy flying and then forget the fucking landing gear. Oh, no, he's not landing. He's some more fancy flying, I think. What's up, Nubs? Is it going to be another F5 mic? Yes, 100%. I think we might even do something like F5 and Harrier versus MiG 21 and... MiG 19, whatever that farming thing was. Whatever the tractor is, we'll do that. We'll get those sorted out for you in March. We've got some Tomcat events coming up as well now that the... Oh, shout out to Heatwork, guys. I don't know if you've been living under a rock all day and you haven't seen anything. Tomcat comes out on the 13th of March, guys. 13th of March, F14 release day. So we are going to have... Carrier Wars at the end of March, which will have the F-14 included. We're also going to do the F-5 MiG-21 event that I already mentioned. We might even do MiG-15 and F-86 as well on next month if we can. If not next month, that'll be in early April, so... Stay tuned. Get yourself, if you want to take part in these PvP competitions, guys, or these PvP events, get yourself signed up on ED forums. You're missing out on a lot of fun. Get to make some epic memories. Alright, I'm going to shoot off, jump into the debrief and see how that goes, see what the guys thought of the event. Thank you so much for watching. Shout out to the streamers that were on, Call Me One, 99 Hera Missy, and 104 Cadet Bullet. Those guys were all streaming in the event, guys, so get yourself onto their channels, watch their replay videos, and we'll see you for the next one. Peace.